and welcome to Round Robin. I'm your host, Robin McCormick with the City of Hampton. And today we're going to talk about the issue of women in public service and a group that exists to further that as employment and promotion. My guest is Lynn Cherry-Miller from our fire department. Welcome.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
I think this is an interesting issue, and particularly, you know, this group, this organization, kind of grew out of fire department,
yes,
which is not a place where you think there are a lot of women, or at least didn't used to be. Tell us that story.
Well, it was established by former Portsmouth Fire Chief Don Horton. He saw a need in his department to provide a path to promotion for women. So it really was designed to break down barriers in the fire service or public safety areas. And it started off with just a meeting of 30 people on the initial meeting.
Oh, wow. And mostly from fire at that time, right?
Yes. Yes.
And it's always been hosted, the annual gathering conference has always been hosted by the fire department.
Yes, it has.
But always in Portsmouth until this year, right?
Yes, this is the first year that the conference has moved outside of its founding city of Portsmouth, Virginia. And I'm very proud to be able to host that this year in service chair.
Okay, so it's in Hampton, and what are the dates?
It's September 19th and 20th. That's a Thursday and Friday, and it'll be at the Hampton Roads Convention Center.
And again, our convention center, drawing people, of course, this is Hampton Roads, probably a lot of them won't spend the night, but bringing people to our city to enjoy the shopping and dining in addition to the conference.
Yes, and we've actually had guests as far away from Hampton as Washington State, Ohio, and Florida.
This could grow, couldn't it?
Yes,
that's
yes.
Exciting.
That's what I'm hoping for this year, is to really grow the conference.
And I love that it has this grassroots start. I mean, it was the chief, but it was also women getting together and, I assume, encouraging each other, supporting
yes.
each other. That's important.
Yes. I remember one of the first meetings, I guess it was, at that time that I attended. And Mary Beth Mikos was there, and Chief Cloud from the Atlanta area. And I was so impressed by the information that they were able to share with the group. Even though I was not a firefighter, I could still benefit from those experiences.
So some of it then is about education and promotion, but I would think it would also just support people, women, who, you know, might feel alone in their departments. You
yes.
look at maybe beyond fire and police, you look, well, sheriff's departments, engineers have traditionally not been a field that a lot of women have gone into. I think we're a little different in Hampton, but we have a female city manager.
Yes.
I mean, women in public service, she is, you know, kind of the role model.
Yes, she is. And along with the conference, we're going to have a panel of distinguished women, and that will be from several fields. And one of our own, Councilwoman Chris Sneed, will participate in that.
Chris has such a good story to tell for this particular group.
Yes.
Because, yeah, she started out as essentially a secretary and moved up to be a department director.
Yes.
And then elected to council after she retired. So there's a lot of promotions and a lot of knowledge in her story and what she was able to do.
Yes. I think all of the different experiences melded together will really be powerful for all of the attendees, men and women.
Now wait, men? Are men
yes.
allowed to come to this line?
Yes. It is open to men. Men are encouraged to attend because they'll get the opportunity to learn about some obstacles that women face that they might not be aware of.
So it might be a little bit of an eye-opener, an education for them in a different way.
Yes. Yes.
So who are you talking to? What is the target group, though, to come?
Well, the target group is all public service areas.
Define that. People might not think about that.
Well, when you think of a municipality, say the city of Hampton, all departments, personnel from all departments are welcome to attend. Even here on our regional committee, we have a member from Hampton who's in the Public Works Department. And traditionally, Hampton has been a strong supporter of the conference. So I'm real glad that to have her involved.
But public service could be other areas too. We've got state workers here. We've
yes.
got federal, ton of people who work for the federal government. So it's pretty broad audience in Hampton Roads.
It is. And really getting the word out to those other areas that you might not normally think of has been a great challenge for us. So we've really worked hard this year on our social media presence.
So tell me about your career in public service. Were you dedicated? Is that what you wanted to do in terms of a career?
Well, what I did actually prior to coming to the city was work for the Daily Press.
No, you did not.
Yes, I did. I was in classified display advertising for 5 years. And I came to the city and started out as a WAE.
You got to tell people what that means. That's a term Hampton uses that nobody understands.
When actually employed, it's the term that Hampton uses for its part-time employees.
There are some regular part-time.
Yes. So I started off in the council office, and then I moved to the city attorney's office. And then I ended up splitting my days between the city attorney's office and the fire department because someone was out on leave. And I was interested in all of those areas, but as it turns out, fire was the first one to have a full-time position available. And that's
so
how
you more fell into it.
Yes.
And then began to appreciate the public service
yes.
aspect of
yes.
it. I think that's true for many of us, maybe.
Yeah, I can truly say that I didn't know much about public service at all before actually getting involved in it. I read a little bit about the council meetings, but it wasn't something that I followed, you know.
Yeah, I know. My passion was journalism, and that was my career. And then as things progressed and journalism changed and life at the, you know, Daily Press got to be a little different, I saw a big need in Hampton because I didn't think we were telling our story. And I think that's, you know, part of what we do is we all give a lot to our careers and are invested in them. But when you're in public service, when you're in journalism too, I think there's some higher purpose in a
yes.
lot of that stuff.
And I think in everything you do, there
sure,
really is.
In the medical field, there's clearly a higher purpose. It's true a lot.
Yeah.
If you're serving others.
Yes. And I think in the fire department, I always say, it's the funnest job in the world, even though it is a job. I mean, there's a lot to be done. But one thing that it's allowed me to do is to be able to express myself creatively. And I love that aspect of it.
Yeah, our jobs, they change a lot. Whether our job descriptions change or whether we're moving up, it's very good in Hampton that we always can take on new challenges
yes.
as employees and as staff. Okay, well, if we want more information about the conference, tell us about your social media and your website now.
Well, we have a conference website for the first time, so I'm very pleased about that. And the website address is hampton.gov/WIPS, W-I-P-S.
Governments love acronyms, and since you came out of governments, there's going to be an acronym.
Yes,
I know
Women
it.
In Public Service, WIPS, W-I-P-S.
Okay.
So
and you have a Facebook page, I think, too?
Yes, we have a Facebook page as well, facebook.com/ WIPS Conference, W-I-P-S Conference.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Lynn. I appreciate you coming by.
Thank you so much for having me.
And thank you for watching. I hope that those of us who are in public service will think about this conference and think about our jobs and what we do in public service and help recruit others because it's a great career. Thanks for watching.